The 2011 earthquake in Virginia, causing significant damage in Baltimore and felt as far away as New York, was a magnitude 5.8, about 30,000 times bigger than the 2.6 magnitude in Baltimore County on Friday.
Earthquakes of this size are fairly common. They're not a reason for alarm.
University of Maryland professor Ved Lekic is a seismologist using earthquakes to study the structure of the Earth's interior. He points out that earthquakes in the historic record for Maryland date back to the 1700s.
We can expect more of earthquakes like the one we felt on Friday. I mean, they're going to be, for every one of the ones that we see back in 2011, we would expect to see about 1,000 earthquakes of the ones we saw on Friday.
And he says we can expect them in this region every few years. It's just harder to predict where.
In a place like the central and eastern United States, there's lots of small faults everywhere. There's no clear kind of single cause of them all. So you can have them pop up here and then in a different location, in a third location, and the relationship is not as clear as it is in a place like California, where the earthquakes will constantly occur on the same main fault zones.
The one in 2011 and on Friday were on different fault lines, and Professor Lekic explained neither are a direct indication of more consistent activity in the future. He says aftershocks like the one over the weekend are to be expected. In fact, he wouldn't be surprised if there's another aftershock in the coming days.
Understanding the aftershock sequence is something that my students look at in particular, understanding how much variability there is in the aftershocks, like how large are they, how quickly they come.
And so just for a little more context here, the 2011 earthquake was extremely unusual, but smaller ones like the one on Friday have been felt in the Baltimore area at least 10 times since the early 90s. Reporting live in Midtown tonight, Kyrie, WBAL-TV 11 News.